You want that? A vintage Enlil? Ugh. It ain't cheap, pal. It's gonna be 5 cats.
He's bluffing. I can get it for 3. Watch this.
3.
5.
Fine, Steve. 4. And that's my last offer.
All right. You're taking flakes out of my minnow's mouth, but fine. 4 it is. Send them over.
I forgot what the hell we were talking about.
We're talking about the transmission, what's also known as the disciplic succession.
Yes. People think, here's the thing that is so important that I want people to understand about magic whenever I talk about it a lot of times. When we're talking about something being an oral tradition, we sort of live under this misunderstanding that that means it's just a bunch of stories told, handed on. That's not what this means. What an oral tradition is, it means the way this current of energy is passed from one person to another is through the voice. You know, our voice is sound waves. We're creating sound waves which carry information. That's why, you know, in the Bible, I always tell people the Bible is the greatest book of magic ever written, once you know how to read it. You know, the whole thing in the very first chapter of the Bible, they're talking about in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. That's because this is an oral tradition. Does that make sense?
You're blowing my mind.
So that goes all the way back to ancient Mesopotamia. And I forgot what
maybe further back. Is it the words that have the energy, or is it the energy coming out of the person saying the words?
Combination of both. For example, you can only pass the current if you've received the current. Like, you could say the exact same words that a person who's holding the current would say, and if you're not holding the current, it's not going to transmit. You have to be holding the current and have the right words. Reasons to do magic. One is for manifesting something, and that can be anything from a parking spot to the career you want, to the relationship you want to be in, whatever it is. The other reason for doing magic is what I call spiritual sustenance, where you are deliberately invoking energy and intelligences that you then absorb into your energy system, into your aura, to make you grow, make you change.
That cat just sloshed me.
That's the mama cat. She's a prankster.